Hey corn growers, I'm Eric Wilson, agronomy manager for Wyffels Hybrids. I'm coming to you today to talk about our Fertility 101, and in fact this is the first episode of our Fertility 101 series, Understanding a Soil Test. So there's lots of things you can talk about on a soil test. For the purposes of today and keeping this short and to the point, I want to focus on three main points. So what do the units mean and why are they important to you as a corn grower? How can you put your numbers to use on your operation? And lastly, I want to talk about focusing on what you can influence on your operation. First thing I always do when I get a new soil test and take a look at it is I go straight to pH. pH is important to all nutrient availability on your operation, so it's obviously the first thing that we want to tackle when we get a new soil test. This particular soil test has 8 samples on it. However, I'm going to go straight to the bottom, and today we're going to focus on the average for the field. So pH is in fact unitless, meaning there's no number after it to indicate anything. And it's important because it affects all the nutrient availability for all the other nutrients that are essential to plant growth. So ideal soil pH is 6.7. Ideal range is 6 to 6.7. And usually we want to start taking action when soil pHs fall below 6, somewhere around 5.7 or less for a field average. As you can see, as we move to the left of this table, things become more acidic, and as we get into the more yellow and red, that would indicate lesser availability of those nutrients at lower soil pH. So, question I get quite often, what is buffer pH? What does it mean to me? The short answer is buffer pH is just a measure of how easily you can actually change the soil pH on your particular field. So the actual purpose of the buffer pH number is used to write liming recommendations. For you guys as growers, unless you are writing your own lime recommendations, it's really something that you don't have to pay too much attention to. More so focus on the actual soil pH for your operation or your field. The next thing, moving on down the line that I then focus on, is phosphorus. So again, going right to the bottom, this particular field has 19 part per million phosphorus. So I mentioned earlier, we'd talk a little bit about what those units mean. If you're not familiar, PPM stands for part per million. That can also be thought of as milligrams per kilogram. To tie that back to your particular soil test, or this one we're talking about today, if you have a PPM of 19, that actually means that you have 19 milligrams of actual phosphorus per kilogram of soil that you sent in. Another way we can think about this, which makes a lot more sense when we start talking applications of fertilizer, if you take part per million times 2, assuming you collected that soil test at a 6-inch depth, that actually gives you the approximate amount of available nutrient on a pounds of nutrient per acre basis. So that brings things a little more back into the realm of what we're talking about in terms of fertilizer applications. To put this as an example, using our same average that we had before, 19 part per million times 2, that actually gives us 38 pounds of phosphorus per acre. So for an example, a 200 bushel per acre corn crop removes 70 pounds of phosphorus in the grain alone. Meaning when you haul that grain off, you're hauling off 70 pounds of phosphorus per acre. However, just for normal plant growth and metabolic function, you need another 30 required to get you to a 200 bushel per acre corn crop. So in this particular instance, we're going to need some additional phosphorus on that acre to get where we need to be in terms of yield. The next thing I like to look at, potassium. Again, going right to the bottom, looking at the average of 105 part per million in this particular field. And we can do those same calculations in terms of potassium. So average K is 105 ppm times 2. That gives us 210 pounds of actual K per acre. A 200 bushel per acre corn crop removes 50 of that when you haul that grain off. However, we know that potassium in particular is important for a lot of other things, including cell wall structure and stress regulation. So we actually need another 220 pounds required just for normal plant growth. Again, a lot of that 220 is going to get returned back to that acre when that stover and plant material is incorporated. but it still uses it during that growing season. So, want to round this out with focusing or talking about focusing on what you can influence. Depending on what state you're in, pretty much everyone has established soil sufficiency levels or optimum levels for things like pH, phosphorus, and potassium. And depending on what state, there's even more established levels, but these are the big three that pretty much everyone has optimum levels for established in their own state. I would encourage you to check into those levels because they can vary within a state depending on what region you're in, and they absolutely vary state to state. Last thing I want to leave you with, disregard the colors that you see on your soil test. Depending on what lab you're using, they might use a different color indicator to identify what they're saying is sufficient or optimum or deficient. Pay attention to the numbers. Use those numbers, relate them back to the recommendations for your particular region and your particular state, and that's what you want to pay attention to. As an example of this, in the state of Iowa, Iowa State recommends that if you have a zinc level of 0.9 or greater, that would indicate that you're optimum or sufficient on zinc. Based on this particular soil test, it's showing that to be orange or in the low range. So keep that in mind when you're looking at your soil tests. Always know what the optimum levels are for your particular region. With that, I hope you guys took something from this. As always, if you have any additional questions, do reach out to your Wyffels representative. Thank you guys so much for your time today.